Hello friends, welcome on stitchingworld.com. Today we'll make this lady's coat or a jacket. These are the measurements. You can use your measurements. You'll need about 2 meter fabric. This is cotton blended fabric, which is thick enough. And while you fold, the width should be about 13 inch. If you are going by these measurements, that should be half of your hip measurement. Fold it plus a few inches. We cut the back part first. We mark the shoulder 7.5 inch, that is half shoulder plus half inch for side seams. The armhole length. The formulas are given. You can calculate your measurements. This is 7.5 inch for the armhole length. Waist length 14.5 inch and total length are taken 24 inch. Later on, after marking, I'll be adding 1.5 inch more on the bottom side. Now we extend these markings. Chest, 1/4 of chest plus 1.5 inch. Waistline would be 3/4 inch lesser than the chest line. And hip line, if you want to make it straight cut, then this is the formula which I have mentioned. So ideally it should be 10 inch, but because I want to make it a little flary from the bottom, I'm keeping it 11.5 inch, that is 1.5 inch extra. Now we mark the sides. So I again insist, if you want to make it a straight coat, keep it exactly as mentioned in the formula that I have given you. Now we mark for a waistline fitting. We mark 3 inch inside from the folded side. This is 3 inch up and 3 inch down, total 6 inch long dart. This is a fish dart, which will be about slightly half inch more from the middle. And I show you how we are going to stitch it. Though at the time of stitching, I'll show you exactly how to do this. But see, this is the shape it will be gaining after finishing. So same way, both the sides of this fold will be having 2 darts. Now we mark the armhole. Same as your shoulder, or you can take about a little half inch lower, but I've taken it same. Neck width is 3 inch, which will go half inch up, and then we'll mark the neckline. See, I took 1.5 inch bottom and 1 inch from the sides, and 1 inch you can exactly mark, and then you can keep on the sides. Then we cut, keeping half inch from the top. We shape the back neck and the shoulder slope would be 3/4 of an inch down, and then we cut the shaping the back armhole. See, it should be both the parts should be cut equally, because fabric is thick, so your needle, this scissors have to be sharp. Now we cut the outlines. The best part about making your jacket yourself, that you can alter it as per your measurements, your requirements, even in future. And from bottom, we'll be cutting slightly going curvier from the end. This is about 3/4 inch up, and then we had given shape. Now we have to cut front. Front would be this way. We have to keep about 1.5 inch on the selvage side or the open side. These are 2 layers, and we keep 1.5 inch for the front opening and we mark the straight line. Then leaving this open side, we start marking the shoulder same as mentioned as marked on the back part, 7.5 inch, armhole length 7.5 inch, same as marked earlier. Here also we check, then the waist length 14.5 and total length, that is 24 inch, plus we had added 1.5 inch for the bottom fold and the seam, so that is also included. We mark it. And then we need to extend these lines. See, the fabric is thick, so in any way it makes sense to cut it separately. Besides, there is some difference of measurement. Like we keep 1/2 inch more than the chest line of the back part. Waistline would be 3/4 inch lesser than this front part chest line. And the bottom, I'm keeping about 1.5 inch flary more than usual as mentioned in the formula. So that is up to you. If you want to make it straight, you go as per the formula mentioned, or you can also keep it 1 inch or 1.5 inch more. Keeping about 3/4 inch from the side, while we join the side markings, we'll be giving slightly round shape from the sides. So if you are making it straight in any way, it won't make much difference even if you don't go very round. So this is the basic markings we made. Now we mark the neckline, that will be same as that of back part, 3 inch. 3/4 inch down for the shoulder slope, and then we join neckline, neck point with the shoulder slope, and the armhole would be curvier and steeper than the back armhole, that would go about 1/2 inch inside, and then we can shape it. The front neckline, because we are adding a collar, coat collar, we keep 3.5 inch down, that includes the shoulder seam. If you don't want to add a collar, you can make a V-neck. Method is slightly different, like you don't need to add a collar. You simply make a V-neck, which will be about 7 inch deeper than this one. Like this is 3.5 inch, that would be 7 inch. So you shape the front neck. Now we need to have 2 darts in the front jacket. So this is 3 inch from the front marking, and this is 2 inch inside from the first marking. So these are 2 darts of 6 inch length, 3 inch up and 3 inch down. Same method as I just shown you how to mark for the darts as I mount on the back part. It will give a very nice fitting on the waist. Now we can add pocket. If you want pocket, you can add a pocket. So we had made one patch pocket pattern in one of the earlier videos. We'll be using that. to make the pocket and then paste it. Patch pockets are very easy. And this jacket making is very simple. You can follow it. If you have any queries, anything to ask, you can ask me and I'll reply to you. Now we keep 1 inch for the seam, side seams, same as marked on the back part of the jacket. It is simple, just I am marking it separately. So it is same thing, just minor change. So now while we have to cut the neckline, we fold from the front and then we cut the neckline. That is the only difference. Once we cut it, then the side cuttings would be on the outer line. Simple. There is nothing which you have to worry about. The shoulder also, you have to cut on the line, the markings and sides and the bottom. Now we cut the long sleeves. To cut, it is the same simple method that I applied for cutting these long sleeves, though there is one more method to cut the sleeves. So I folded the fabric, the back side out, and two sleeves we need. We keep length of the sleeve plus 2 inch more, like 24 inch for the length. Chest length is 7.5 inch, and 3.5 inch I kept inside, and keeping about 1 inch for the side seam, we cut the sleeves. If you have any confusion, any query or anything to ask, you can ask me. So this is how we cut basic two sleeves. You can watch my earlier videos also to exactly know how to cut the sleeves if you have any doubts. Now we give shape to the front armhole. So the right side of the sleeves inside and the back part, back side out, and then we give the shape to our sleeves. So this is how our sleeves are cut. I am not adding lining to make this jacket making easier for you. Now we cut the patch pockets. See, using the paper pattern or a cardboard pattern that we made earlier, we just keep this. You can make about like 5.5 inch wide and about 6 inch long, adding about 1/2 inch or 1 inch from the sides for the folding. Just keep the fabric, keep the pattern, this thing, and then cut two patch pockets. It's very simple and very useful, very functional, and we'll be folding it from the sides, and then we'll press it, and I'll show you in detail while we'll be stitching the jacket. So stay subscribed to watch the stitching part of this jacket making. I'll show you in detail step by step, and if you have any doubt or anything to ask me, you can ask me. To know more about the suit fabrics, you can visit stitchingworld.com to know which fabric to choose for your jacket or for your suit. So stay subscribed, keep watching, keep sharing. Take care. Goodbye.